In this video, we're going to be looking at angles within parallel lines. Now, there are three situations here, which you may be familiar with already, but today we're going to look a little bit more in detail, how to remember them and what their proper names are. So this first one, a lot of you may remember as a Z angle. Now, we don't want to remember it like this. It's very good being able to recognize the Z, but the proper name for it is alternate angles. And you can see the alternate angles are these two angles here. And the special thing about alternate angles is they are the same. Next, we have what some of you may know as the F angles. Again, we don't want to remember it as the F angles. The proper name for this one is corresponding angles. And again, if you have a look at them, it might give away a little hint, but they are also equal to each other. They are the same. Finally, we have the co-interior angles, or the C angles. Again, we want to use co-interior. And unlike the other two, these two aren't actually the same. These two add together to make 180 degrees. So very similar to how a triangle or a straight line works. And as long as you can remember these three, then you'll be completely fine with all of these topics. Now, in terms of remembering it, I always remember personally that the Z pairs with the alternate angles because Z and A are opposite ends of the alphabet. Now, going down to C and the co-interior angles, you can see the C shape and the fact that co-interior begins with a C helps me remember this one. And corresponding, if I'm honest, is kind of just the other one. So as long as you can remember the three words and you compare two of them, then the last one by process of elimination is going to be the corresponding angle. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope that helped.